Hello, Paragon International University students and possibly instructors. This is Mengleang from the engineering faculty. As I receive a lot of questions regarding the grading system, in this video, we're gonna take a closer look at how the grading systems really work. Now, if you were to plot out the overall percentage of a class, you would see that a small number of students, maybe two or three students, will receive a really high grade or really high percentage. And another small number of students receive really bad grades, really small percentage. And the rest of the class or the majority of the class would fall somewhere in the middle. Okay, and we usually call this curve as bell curve. Now, the system would automatically divide this curve into 9 segments with the width of 0.4 standard deviation. Then, the system would fail the student who fall into these two groups or two standings or two segments. Their letter grade would be F. Then next one, DD, DC, CC, CB, BB, BA, and lastly, AA. In other words, if a student receives the overall percentage higher than this point, which is average plus 1.4 times standard deviation, the student will be awarded letter grade AA. Or if a student whose percentage is within these two points, within average minus 0.6 standard deviation and average minus 0.2 standard deviation within this region, the system will suggest letter grade DC. This calculation would work or would be applicable for 90% of the time. However, the system also has some adjustments to be applied on top of the previous calculation. Now let's look at the first adjustment. I usually call this one boundary condition to my students, to my first year students. Okay, for the students who was initially granted letter grade F, but their percentage is higher than 50%, the system would automatically change the letter grade from F to DD. And second one, it's a bit scary. For students whose overall percentage is less than 30%, they will fail the course or they will get letter grade F. Now, before we look at adjustment number two, I want you to look at this order. So two Fs, one AA. Now, adjustment number two. For the case that no student is awarded AA, or in other words, no students has the overall percentage higher than average plus 1.4 standard deviation, the system would shift this grade one step down. So only one F now and two AAs. Okay, let's look at a spreadsheet that I prepared. And this data was from last year. So this is a class with 31 students. So these are their name. Obviously, I would change it. And these are their overall percentages. So student A got 72.3%. And as you can see, there are two blank cells. This represents student N and student V. They did not show up for their final assessments. They either didn't come to the final exam or they didn't submit their final project. So we exclude their percentage from this calculation. In other words, we don't take their percentage into calculation. Now, first, I would find the average of this class. So average of these percentages, and it's 60.3%. Then the standard deviation of this data set, It is 13.34. Now, if you recall earlier, the boundary to get AA or the threshold to get AA was average plus 1.4 standard deviation. In this case, it's equal to 79.0. So any student whose overall percentage is higher than 79.0, they'll get AA. And so on. Now let me sort this percentage. Okay, as you can see, these two students, their percentage is higher than 79, so they got AA. And so on. Okay, if you wonder, this cell is just a bunch of if functions. Okay, and these students, they fail. And the two who did not show up for their final assessment, they earn letter grade NP. Or NP stands for not present. Okay, this is just some overall summary. Two students got AA and so on. Now let's head back to our presentation. So this is my personal opinion on the bell curve system. So the first benefit of this system is that it will ensure the education quality that Paragon International University provides. It has built in competitiveness factor. In other words, students' grade is compared to their peer instead of a certain fixed percentage. Also, the system would ensure fairness. For example, one course or one class, the instructor gives really easy assessment, and the other class, the instructor give really hard exams. So the system would make the calculation fair between those two classes. In other words, the suggested letter grade that we use is independent from the difficulty level of the assessment. Okay, from personal experience, I do have some tips for instructors as well. So first one, in your Google Classroom, please use the grading rubric. There are many benefits of using rubrics. One, the grading process would be way easier for you, for instructors. And two, the grade that you give to students would be more objective. In other words, we remove bias when we grade. And also students, when they look at their grade from the rubrics perspective, they know which area to improve. Okay, for the course that heavily based on the group project, I would highly encourage to include in the grading rubric the criteria to account for individual students' performance. Let's say, for example, if a course that is heavily based on presentation, we as instructor can add the criteria of, let's say, presentation skill that we will judge based on individual students' presentation skill. Or we can ask questions at the end of their presentation to assess how much they know, how much they learned about a certain topic. Okay, this is where the bell curve system is not good. So for small class, let's say a class that has less than 10 students. It's a small class, so the sample size is not good for the bell curve. So in this case, I would recommend use the percentage-based grading. Percentage-based means, let's say, okay, this is just an example. If the student got the overall percentage of higher than 90%, straight AA, higher than 85, and lower than 90, BA, and so on. Now for students, my advice for you, in any exams, any assignment, any assessment, don't look at the absolute value, Let's say don't be happy when you got 80% from an exam. You should compare it to the average. Let's say 80%, if the average of the class is 60, then you are doing really well. If the average of the class is instead 85, you are not doing well at all. Okay, and for students, if you want to read more, you can check this calculation or read the student handbook in page 26 and page 18. Okay, thank you.